Let's talk about tabs. So many users are already pretty familiar with how tabs work because they use Google Chrome, they use Firefox, and you'll see that some of those behaviors from those internet browser tabs will carry over into GitKraken client. In this lesson, I'll cover what a new tab is. We'll talk about repo tabs, terminal tabs, and workspace tabs. The terminal tab and workspaces will get their own video, but I'll still give you a brief high-level description of what each of these do. All right, so I'm in GitKraken client, and what I'll do here is I have a repo tab already open, and here at the toolbar, I can see that commit speedrun is highlighted as that's the tab I have selected. You'll notice as I hover over any of these tabs that I'll get a little bit more information about, of course, the name of the repo, but also the breadcrumbs, so that where in my directory is this repo host, is this repo located? And if you have a terminal tab open, which I'll get to, you know, which directory am I looking at? So what I'll show you here is you can click the plus icon from anywhere in the application and you should be able to create a new tab. So this is the new tab view. It may look a little different depending on which version you're running, but you should still see shortcuts to open repos you've recently opened. You'll have quick shortcuts to open a repo. So I can click on this and I can browse to repository like I did in a previous lesson. We have shortcuts to open workspaces or create a new workspace or to add a terminal tab. But before I show you how these work, I do also want to show you that we have links to additional resources. Again, this might update depending on which version you are running, but this is a great place to explore our support documentation if you want to learn about the finer details of certain features. Okay, so let's go back to a repo tab here, and I just want to show you a little bit about the navigation. So you can switch between different tabs, much like you would in an internet browser, just by clicking on the branch, on the repo name in the tab, and that'll switch you right over. If you right-click on a repo tab or any tab, you'll have actions like closing the tab, close other tabs, close tabs to the right, or you can even create an alias. So yes, if you wish to name this something else because maybe all of your repos have the same prefix, if you want to condense that to an alias, this is where you can, let's see, GK docs, I'll just call that. You can save it as an alias, and there you go. You now have a name. Hopefully it's a little bit easier to recognize in the repo tab name, but it doesn't really change. It's only an alias, so we're not overwriting anything specific to the repo. Next, you can also, if you have lots of tabs, and maybe it's very difficult to read or distinguish between different tabs, you can use this tabs list icon here to pull up and search through your tabs. So let me pull up, for example, docs. And so this will filter my tabs list, and I can click to then open GK docs. I already have it open here. Or I can click to open a recently closed tab that also matches my result. But even if you don't type anything in the filter, you can explore the list of tabs that you currently have open right from this drop-down menu. Okay, one other thing I'll show you is that like I showed you before that you can close tab just by right-clicking, but you can also use the middle click of your mouse. So I'm using a mouse that has a, let me get it in the camera, this little wheel, and that has a click. I can middle click to then close that tab. That might be something you can do in your internet browser too, in case you didn't know that. Okay, I'll next show you the terminal tab. So I'm in a new tab, and I'm going to click new terminal tab. Sorry, a lot of T's and tabs. And this will open up the terminal tab where you may run commands much like you do in any terminal you have on your machine. We do have some added features here, so we have some auto-suggest and auto-complete features for npm, for yarn, oops, there you go, yarn, for git. So git is pretty actually pretty nice because you can do git add and will give you a lot of help in completing those commands. And we also have our own proprietary GK commands. Now again, this will get its own video where I'll go in depth into what this can do. But for now, all you need to know is that if you want to run a quick command, you can do so from a terminal tab. Or if you remember from our toolbar video, you can also just run the terminal panel from within a repo tab as well. So same idea here. Okay, finally, I want to show you the workspace tab. So you can click from a new tab view to open workspaces. And that's what I'll do in this case. I'll click to open workspaces, and this will bring up all the workspaces that you have on your machine or that you have up on the cloud. So workspaces are groupings of repositories, and that grouping has power because, you know, you are able to then get information about, all right, what was I working on? It's Monday morning. What was I working on Friday? You can get quick information on like which branch you have checked out. This is a team repository and I don't have all of the repos cloned, so I can go ahead and provision any of the remaining repos just by doing a multi-clone. So there's a number of actions that are available here, and I encourage you to explore it or at least navigate over to the workspaces video in this course. But for now, all you need to know is that you can click X here from the workspace tab to collapse it. And you can always navigate to the workspace, to your list of workspaces by clicking this icon here in the top left, and it'll open back to wherever you were in your workspace. All right, so we've talked about the different ways that you can interact with tabs in GitKraken Client. There's still so much more there, but I think you have a good start, and I hope you enjoy.